Hello and welcome to my channel Anyone Can Cook with Christian and my little friend Mickey. Today we cook again a dish from Walt Disney World in Orlando in Florida. And to make the connection between Europe and Florida, we traveled to the Disney Park Epcot. In the restaurant Beer Garden is offered a buffet that is based on the German cuisine. They have also a delicious cheese beer soup. And that is what we will cook today. Stop! Stop! Wait a moment! Mickey, did you actually buy the beer for the beer and cheese soup? Oh, weh! Now we have a real problem. Servus! I heard you will cook today a cheese beer soup. Therefore, I brought you my favorite beer and some pretzels. Fantastic! The soup is saved. And I also have a good idea for the pretzels. Epcot is one of four theme parks at Walt Disney World in Orlando, Florida, and opened in 1982 after the Magic Kingdom. Epcot has around 120 hectares and was the largest theme park in Walt Disney World until 1998. Later, Disney's Animal Kingdom was the largest theme park. The park has two main areas: Future World and World Showcase. Both areas are designed like one of the world exhibitions in the first third of the 20th century, but above all based on the model of the New York World's Fair of 1939. In this way, Epcot became a permanent exhibition location for a specific selection of nations in the world: Mexico, Norway, China, Germany, Italy, USA, Japan, Morocco, France, Great Britain and Canada. There is also the German Pavilion. It looks like a typical German small town from the Middle Ages. Elements from the different regions of Germany are represented. You can find a statue of St. George and the Dragon on the square. There is also a bell tower. There is also the German restaurant Biergarten. I have already been there. They offer a buffet with typical German food: sauerkraut, sausage, roast pork and red cabbage, and also wheat beer. You almost think you are outside, but you are in a dark hall with many beautiful lighting effects. They have fantastic German music. And you can get the delicious cheese beer soup. A good keyword. And for that, we need the following ingredients: 250 grams of smoked bacon or vegetarian minced meat, 4 tablespoons of butter, means 100 grams, 3 diced celery sticks, a diced red onion, a cup of flour, 20 grams, 3 cups of vegetable broth, 4 cups of whole milk, 0.8 liters, 500 grams of mixed mountain cheese and cheddar cheese or mozzarella cheese, salt, pepper, 1 tablespoon of Tabasco, 1 tablespoon of Worcester sauce, a cup of warm beer, means 0.2 liters, a pretzel, rosemary powder, and smoked paprika powder.
So.
While others are already sitting in the beer garden and having a cool beer, let's prepare together the cheese and beer soup. And that it goes a little bit faster, I use some Disney magic today. Bibbidi, bobbidi, boo. It worked really well with the Disney magic. Now we can start. First I put some butter in a pot and fry the vegetarian minced meat. This is made from soybeans. The original recipe is with bacon. But today we are making the recipe in a vegetarian version. I have a good advice for you. I season with smoked paprika powder, then we have a delicious smoke aroma. I add the celery and the chopped onion. I fry everything well.
Und eine klein gehackte Zwiebel. Und lasse alles gut anbraten.
Normally, I would add the flour now and we would make a classic roux. But I prefer to mix the flour with some water and to add it later. Then I have fewer lumps. I first add the vegetable broth. And let it boil. When the soup cooks, I add the water flour mixture. Mmm, how that smells! It smells really delicious. Now I'm gradually adding the milk. Not all at once, so that the soup doesn't clump. We sprinkle the cheese in the soup and then I add some warm beer. If you take cold beer, the soup may form lumps. Now I can reduce the heat a bit and season the soup with a little salt and pepper. Then another tablespoon Tabasco sauce. And a tablespoon of Worcester sauce. The soup has to simmer now for around 20 minutes. And in the meantime, I prepare my topping. For this, I use pretzels today, which I fry in a pan, seasoned with some rosemary powder. I take some butter. I need a little bit more heat for that. Now I add the pretzels. And season with some rosemary powder. That smells really delicious. The combination of pretzels and rosemary powder is simply unique. The pretzels are well roasted now. The soup takes about 10 minutes more. And meanwhile, I will tell you something about a nice destination in Florida. The Florida Keys. The distance from Epcot to Key Largo is 300 miles. Which are approx 480 kilometers. The car ride takes about 4.5 hours. The name Keys is derived from the Spanish word Cay. That means something like sand island on a coral reef. It is a popular destination for fishing, boating, snorkeling and diving. Until a hurricane in 1935, the islands were connected by a railway line. Today, the islands are connected. We have 42 bridges of the Overseas Highway, which was built in place of the railway line. From Key Largo, you need 95 miles to Key West, which are approximately 150 kilometers. the most famous bridge is the 7-mile bridge. As you see from the name, this bridge is 7 miles long, which are 11 kilometers. The car ride would take 2 hours without a break, but there's a lot to see. The Keys consist more than 200 coral islands, with a total length of over 290 kilometers. They extend from the southern point of Florida between the Atlantic and the Gulf of Mexico. The most southern city, Key West, is known for its bar district on Duval Street. The evening sunset celebration at Mallory Square and the Ernest Hemingway House are world famous. On the Keys, you can find exceptional plants and animal species that you not find otherwise in the USA. The Keys form the most northern point of their spread. The climate allows many imported plants to grow. Almost every potted flower and southern plant thrives in this climate. The Keys are also home to some exceptional animal species, such as the protected Key white-tailed deer and the American crocodile. You have also been to the Florida Keys before. Sure, you have to tell something about it. I was there for the first time in 1993. And actually, I have something to tell, even if I'm a little embarrassed. Immediately after our arrival at the airport, we got a rental car, and on the trip, we listened all the time to music from CD and didn't turn on the radio. Arriving on the Keys, there was a big traffic jam. But luckily, only down from the Keys and not in our direction. We were very pleased. Yes, we were a little surprised, but thought that it might be the end of the vacation period. We really enjoyed the trip and took a lot of breaks and went swimming, until we were asked in the parking lot if we didn't know that a hurricane is coming. We went straight back to the mainland and looked for a hotel. In the evening, we were recognized at the reception. During the day, a television team from the news channel Channel 5 has filmed us. We were shown in this report. Two stupid tourists who go to the Keys and go swimming there despite a coming hurricane. That was extremely embarrassing. I can believe. Fortunately, it didn't happen to me. The soup is ready now, so we can start serving. That sounds pretty good. Then I will go to get a glass of beer. It tastes delicious, but I think it needs a little salt and some Tabasco. Just perfect. Then we can start serving. I put some of the cheese beer soup on a plate.
Schöpflöffel der Biersuppe in einen großen Teller.
And then I add some of the roasted pretzels. A little green from the celery and decorate the soup with some pepper.
Ich dekoriere das Ganze noch mit etwas Pfeffer.
Voilà, bon appetit. Guten, Prost! So, that's everything for today. I hope you enjoyed watching the video. And don't forget, if you liked the video, give me a like. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell button. Goodbye, Christian, my little friend Mickey.
Und ich. Servus. Macht's gut.